Majority of us are in opposition. We must also respect the government side, although they are minorities. They are minority and they must also have a say. Although we must have our way. So, majority, I'm jamboni. Minority, I'm jamboni. Mimi nataka niseme hivi. Nataka niseme hivi. Mimi ni mtu wa opposition. I'm a member of the opposition. And one of my duties is to oversight this government, to criticize this government, to criticize the hopeless policies of the Kenya Kwanza regime. The hopeless policies, the draconian and the primitive policies of the Kenya Kwanza regime. That is my mandate. And I want to say this, before I speak on this AU issue, I want to say that kulikuwa na mtu mmoja aliandikwa kazi kwa hoteli. Alipoandikwa kazi kwa hoteli, wateja wakawa kazi ya upishi. Wateja wakawa wanakuja.
Nick,
sana chakula sio mzuri. Wateja wengine wakawa wanalalamika tumbo. Wateja wengine wakawa wanalalamika chakula sio mzuri, haipiki vizuri. Wateja wote walikuwa wanalalamika. Mpishi akasema wateja wameingiliwa na mapepo. Mpishi wa hiyo hoteli. Ile kitu nasema ni kwamba William Samoei Ruto, Daktari William Samoei Ruto, President of the Republic of Kenya, is the biggest problem in this country. Hata umpatie CS wazuri namna gani, hata umpatie maexperts aina gani, because Dr. Ruto himself is the 22 CS. Dr. Ruto is the 47 county commissioners. Dr. Ruto is everything. He is everything. Dr. Ruto ni kama Ten Hag. Ten Hag hata umpatie Messi, umpatie Neymar, umpatie Mbappe, umpatie nani? Umpatie hao wote. Ten Hag hangeweza kusaidia Man U ishinde anything. Hata Blue Shield haangeshinda. Ruto ni kama Ten Hag. Hata umpatia maexperta ina gani. The problem is Dr. William Samoei Ruto. If you don't solve that problem, we are going nowhere. Ruto was not qualified to be a president. It was a very big mistake. It was a very big gamble. It was a suicidal decision in this country. And that is why we find ourselves where we are. Leo nimepitia kotini. There are three university students who were arrested. Our university students were arrested for posting on X a casket of our former president. I think it was Moi or Kibaki. Na wakawa wakapost wakasema, mwili wa rais sasa unatoka wapi? Leave funeral. Na wakashikwa wakashitakiwa. Na walikuwa wameandika RIP Ruto. Hao wanafunzi walikuwa wameandika hivyo. Lawyer wao anaitwa Dunstan Omari. I attended that case yesterday. And the lawyer said like this. The lawyer told the magistrate. He said, "Your Honor, in order for us to proceed with this matter, my clients have been charged with the posting RIP Ruto. So the aggrieved person, namely Ruto, must present himself in this court and prove that he is not dead." Your Honor,
There are thousands and thousands of Rutos in this country. Some of them are dead and some are alive. So this Ruto thing, who thinks that it is him, let him present himself here to prove that he is alive. Your case is Meisha him. Can Ruto go to court to stand and say I'm not dead? So what I'm saying is this. I'm saying that Dr. Ruto is an incompetent president. Dr. William Samoei Ruto. On 19th November 2023, President Ruto lied to Kenyans that they would be treated for free from January 2024. How many of you have been treated for free? From January 2024. On December 11th, 2022, President Ruto lied saying that all Kenyans that would attend Jamhuri Day celebrations at Nyayo National Stadium would get free scholarships from Arizona University. How many Kenyans have got free scholarships from Arizona University? On June 26, 2017, Ruto promised to build 9 stadiums. How many of them have been built? On June 29, 2022, Ruto promised every household, every market and every school a free internet. How many markets in this country have free internet? How many schools? How many? And let me not continue enumerating the promises because of time. But if I had time, I would have taken you through all those promises, including digital centers at every ward, 1,450 wards. No ward, no single ward in Kenya as a digital set up to now. No single word. That is why watoto wa university, mahali alikuwa kwa graduation leo, they heckled him. Wakasema uongo. Unatuambia uongo. Because we have a president who have normalized lying. The Catholics have said he's a liar. Anglicans have said he's a liar. Akorinos have said it's a liar. NCCK has said it's a liar. ADC have said it's a liar. ADC is under NCCK. So let me finalize, Mr. Speaker, by saying that President Ruto is the worst president that Kenya has ever had. Don't expect anything from him. I'm here to counsel you and to tell you to lower your hopes. And don't expect anything from him. The only thing that you should expect from Ruto, and that one we wanted from him, the constitution of IBC. Only that. We don't need a road from him. We don't need a hospital. We need nothing from him. Nothing. Only IBC. That is the only thing we want from him. Because he will deliver nothing. He will deliver nothing. He won't deliver anything. Siya alisema atikashekwa, hii serikali iweze kuperform. Uchumi ya Kenya haiwezi kugrow kwa sababu ya Kashako. Akatoa Kashako. Sasa amechange tena anasema uchumi ya Kenya haiwezi kugrow kwa sababu kuna mapepo yameingia Kenya. Alafu tena amesema uchumi ya Kenya haiwezi kugrow kwa sababu animal farting. Ng'ombe kunyamba nyamba. So ng'ombe inafaa tisikuwe vaccinated tuache kunyamba nyamba na kuharibu hewa. Next time he will blame something else. He will say Christmas in a sababisha. Next time he will blame something else. He has got excuses for his failures. Akona excuses tumbu njima for his failures. Mambo kama ya Adani kujenga hii airport. If I was asked, how do you want us to finance the construction of a modern airport? Here NSSF, ikona billions. Na here NSSF has invested in real estate, in everything, in pesa yetu. NSSF wako na 95 billion. They have. Tunaweza patia NSSF hiyo kazi. Kazi tuambie build for us a modern airport. Yes. We can give it to Equity Bank. We can give it to local investors. We just do a competitive bidding process and we get an investor. Kuliko kuleta huyo fraudster huyo mkora. Na tufanye kama Rwanda vile wanafanya. Wanajenga a new airport. They have not interfered with the old one. So mimi kwa sababu ya time, Mr. Speaker, acha niseme kitu ya mwisho kuhusu uongozi hapa.